Yay to e-test is linked to the CEFR, which is the Common European Framework for Languages, Learning, Teaching, Assessment. It organizes language proficiency in six levels, A1 to C2. So A1 and B2 being basic user level, B1, B2 independent user, C1, C2 proficient user. In 2020, the companion volume was published, and there the approach is slightly different, and you can see it here on the right. The levels here are defined through can-do descriptors, and so is the feedback that we provide to the students who take the test. So the test is an A2 test, and it assesses or evaluates four skills: reading, writing, listening, and speaking. As far as the reading skills are concerned, A2 students should be able to understand everyday signs and notices in public places. They should be able to pick out the main information in short news reports and messages, and they should be able to find specific information in simple everyday texts, provided the contents are familiar. So you can assume that in this test, the students will have to look at signs and notices and show that they can understand what those signs and notices mean. They will read short news reports and messages, and they will have to find specific information in simple everyday texts. A2 students should be able to take simple notes when they are listening to a clear and simple presentation. Of course, again, the subject matter should be familiar. They should be able to copy familiar words and short phrases, and they should be able to exchange information by email, responding to questions from the other person. So, looking at these can-do statements or these descriptions here, the students in the test will have to copy familiar words and short phrases. They will have to take simple notes, and they will have to write a short email. As far as their listening skills are concerned, they should be able to follow short, simple social exchanges. They should be able to recognize specific information in simple dialogues, and they should be able to follow very simple, well-structured presentations. The key word or the key phrase here is that the topic has to be familiar. A2 students should be able to manage simple exchanges concerning their interests, likes and dislikes, habits and routines, past activities, plans and arrangements in very simple language. They should be able to describe people, places, activities and possessions in very simple terms, and they should be able to pronounce familiar everyday words and simple phrases clearly, with a fairly accurate stress, rhythm and intonation. The development process of the Year 7 computer-based test started 3 years ago in 2018, and it has been piloted 3 times. More than 1,000 students have taken the test, and more than 50 schools have been involved in the piloting process. Also, there are 2 research papers that have been written, and in those research papers, the test, its tasks and the assessment have been thoroughly analyzed. Also, we've had 2 assessment experts helping us. And the experts are from Tallinn University and the University of Tartu. The students take the test in ACE, which is the National Exams and Tests platform, and the students will need headphones and a microphone in order to take the test. It can be taken in Chrome or Firefox, as ACE does not work on Apple devices. The test consists of four parts, the first being the reading test. In the reading test, there are five tasks, and the task types used are multiple choice, matching, and capfill, which are the most commonly used foreign language tasks in foreign language textbooks and exams. The second part of the test is the writing test. There's only one short task where the students will have to write a short email. The third part is the listening test. And there are four tasks. And again, the task types are multiple choice, matching, and gapfill. The speaking test can be taken on another day after the written tests, and there the students will have to complete six tasks. The first one being the read aloud task. Then they will have to answer some questions, correct some sentences. They have to describe a picture and ask some questions, and leave a voice message. Compared to paper-based tests, computer-based tests definitely save time and energy because auto-grading or automated assessment can be used, which means that not all students' answers will have to be marked by teachers. Computers can do it instead. Also, it is more standardized because all the students take the tests in very similar conditions. And our experience shows that both students and assessors find it more convenient to take and to assess, as it's more time-saving. Unfortunately, auto-grading means that students with special needs cannot really take computer-based tests in Estonia yet. Hopefully, it will happen in the future when schools let us know that they have some special needs students who would like to take the test. We can organize it and make sure that their answers will be marked the way they should.